Good morning, children. Sai Ram. Welcome to the revision lecture of lesson number 2 of history, that is New Kings and Kingdoms. Now, children, in this today's session, we are going to revise few things which we have already covered in the explanation of the chapter. But along with it, we are also going to see the important places which you might have in your examination for location of map. Okay. Now, children, the first topic that we are going to revise today is the emergence of new dynasties. Children, at the beginning of the 7th century, okay, there were domination of big landlords, okay, or warrior chiefs in different regions of the subcontinent. Existing king recognized them as their subordinates or the samantas. Now, children, now that we have come across the term dynasty, let us understand what is dynasty. A dynasty of rulers, okay, who rule over the country for a long period of time. So, what is dynasty? It is a family of rulers who rule over a country for a long period of time, right? Then what is kingdom? Any country which is ruled by a monarch, that is a king or a queen, is considered to be a kingdom. So, children, as I said, the existing kings, okay, they recognize them as their subordinates or samantas. After gaining of power and wealth gradually, they declared themselves as the Mahasamantas or Mahamandaleshwara. Now, what is Mahamandaleshwara? Mahamandaleshwara is the great lord of a circle or a region. Right? So, sometimes what happened was they rejected the supremacy of the existing king and asserted their independence. Now, children, we have seen the terms like dynasty and kingdom. Now, let us understand what is empire. An empire can be said as a large kingdom or is traditionally larger than a kingdom and may consist of different regions of nations under its control. So, children, who were the Samantas? What have we learned now? Who are the Samantas? They were the big landlords or warrior chiefs, the subordinates to existing kings, and they expected to bring gifts to their kings. So, they were expected to get gifts for their kings. So, children, as explained earlier or as revised earlier, this Danti Durga, okay, he was a Samanta of Chalukyas, that is in Karnataka, and he overthrew his Chalukya overlord. He performed a ritual called Hiranyagarbha. What is it called? Hiranyagarbha. That is the golden womb. Why did he do this? Because he wanted to become Kshatriya, right? So, children, the Samantas, they were expected to bring the gifts to their king, right? Yes. Now, as the Samantas gained power and wealth, they declared themselves to be Mahasamanta or Mahamandaleshwara, right? They also provided military support and attended the king's court. So, sometimes they asserted their independence from their overlords. Now, children, one such instance was that the Rashtrakutas in the Deccan, okay, they were the subordinates to the Chalukyas of Karnataka. But in the mid 18th century, Danti Durga, that is a Rashtrakuta chief, okay, He overthrew his Chalukya overlord and he formed a ritual which is called Hiranyagarbha. Okay, and what does Hiranyagarbha mean, children? It means the golden womb. So children, when this ritual was performed with the help of Brahmanas, it was thought to lead to the rebirth of the sacrificer as Kshatriya, even if he was not only one by birth. So now let us see the new kings and the dynasties, okay, that came up during that period. It was Danti Durga, who was a Rashtrakuta chief in the Deccan. Remember Mayura Sharman in Karnataka, Gurjara Pratihara Harishchandra in Rajasthan. Children, look at this picture. It is a wall relief from cave 15, Ellora. Okay. What does it show? It is showing Vishnu in Narasimha Avatar, that is the man lion. And it is the work of Rashtrakuta period. Children, in some cases, men from enterprising families, they use their military skills to carve out kingdoms. For example, the Kadamba Mayura Sharman and the Gurjara Pratihara Harishchandra. They were the Brahmanas, okay? They gave up their traditional professions and they took to arms. They took to arms successfully, establishing kingdoms in Karnataka and Rajasthan respectively. Now, in this adjoining figure, children, you can see the one which is given in the light pink color, okay, shows the rule of Kadamba Mayura Sharman and Gurjara Pratiharas. Now, let us sum up the facts till now, okay. Danti Durga was the ruler of Rashtrakuta dynasty. Mayura Sharman was the ruler of Kadamba dynasty. Harishchandra was the ruler of Gurjara Pratihara dynasty. Okay, this is very important. You need to know this. If you want, you can jot it down. Now, children, look at this picture. This is a picture of the fluctuating frontiers of those dynasties or those rulers. Okay, the one which is up over here is of Chahamanas, okay. Then we have Palas and we also have Rashtrakutas over here. And the fluctuating boundary or the frontier is this one, this portion. Can you see this over here? See this one, this one. This is the fluctuating frontier, okay. Yeah, so let us look at the next topic, administration in the kingdoms now, okay. Now, children, many of the new kings, okay, they adopted high sounding titles. For example, Maharaja Adhiraj, that is a great king or overlord of kings. Tribhuvana Chakravartin, that is lords of three worlds, and so on. Now, children, in spite of these claims, they shared their power with Samantas and with associations of peasants, traders, and Brahmanas. The kings collected taxes or part of their produce from the producers, that is, peasants, cattle keepers, and artisans. So, children, as I said, in each of these the states, okay, the resources they were obtained from the producers, that is the peasants, the cattle keepers, the artisans, who were often persuaded either or compelled to surrender part of what they produced. Sometimes these were claimed as rent due to to the lord who asserted that he owned the land. Revenues were also collected from the traders. Okay, so children, what kind of taxes or what was collected as taxes that time? Whatever was produced by the peasants, the cattle keepers, the artisans, okay, they had to pay whatever, a part of what they had produced as a rent that was due to the lord. Okay, why? Because he asserted that he owned the land. Now children, let us understand why were the taxes collected. Okay, these resources, that is the taxes, okay, they were used to finance the king's establishment as well as for the construction of the temples and forts. They were also used to fight wars, which were in turn expected to lead to the acquisition of wealth in the form of plunder and access to the land as well as trade routes. Okay, so why were the taxes collected? First, finance king's establishment in construction of temples and forts, to fight wars, to undertake wars on other kingdoms, to acquire foreign lands and wealth. Okay, now one more thing. Okay, why were the taxes collected? They were also used as resource. Why? To fight the wars, to access trade routes by land and seas. The functionaries for collecting revenue were generally recruited from influential families, and positions were often hereditary. This was true about the army as well. Okay, in many cases, close relatives of the kings held these positions. Let us move on to your favorite session, that is quiz time. Let us see what the first question is. In the mid 8th century, Danti Durga overthrew his Chalukya overlord and became the chief of, what is the answer children? Rashtrakuta, Chola, Brahmana or Samanta? The correct answer is Rashtrakuta. What is Vetti? Revenue? Is it tax? Is it rent? Or is it gold? What is it children? Vetti is nothing but tax. Now we move on to the last one. Many new dynasties emerged after 15th century, 7th century, 6th century or 12th century. What is the answer children? What is the answer children? Answer is, yes, I'm sure you must have guessed it right. It is 7th century. So children, with this I end the first part of revision lecture of history chapter 2, that is new kings and kingdoms. See you in the next chapter. Till then, take care and keep learning.